Right, hi friends. So welcome back to another video. Now this is PK sir. So I'm back again. Right friends, so this time we came up with another important topic that we have been hearing, every now and then on the news channels, even on newspaper, everywhere, even on social media, etc, etc, etc. And that topic is NPA. Right? So this lecture is on how to solve the NPA mess. Right guys, so without wasting any further time, I am Prasanna Kumar, PK sir, and welcome to my channel. And of course, last but not least, if you like this video and if you like my effort, you please hit that like button as well as try to what? Subscribe to my channel. And last but not least, try to comment, because each and every comment of yours will make a lot of difference. And don't forget to share it on Facebook or on social media, whether it's WhatsApp or Twitter. But I want you guys to comment and share, because these two things will really help me. So consider this seriously. And then, yeah. Okay, so let's start up. So what is this NPA? I hope already you have an idea. But anyway, let me give you a brief idea of what NPA is. NPA stands for non-performing assets. Now, assets means, I hope you already have an idea. Now, this is from whose perspective? Bank perspective. So from bank's point of view, what will be the assets for banks? For banks, the assets will be loans. You got it? So, and this is on the liability side. I'm just trying to show you, okay? So for bank, always the assets will be loans, and the liabilities for banks will be all the deposits, because they have to repay all these deposits, right? Don't take this seriously, because generally liabilities will be on this side and assets will be on this side. I'm just trying to give you a small idea of what is NPA. So generally what happens in the context of bank gives loan. So let's say there is a person called X. He takes a loan. So which means he has to pay the loan back to the bank, which means bank is expecting the loan to be repaid. So all the loans from the perspective of bank are assets. So now what do you mean by non-performing assets, NPAs? Which means somebody has taken loan, like Vijay Mallya, for example, or Nirav Modi, whoever it is. Okay. And these guys have taken loan and finally their business is not doing well, or intentionally, whatever it is, we can call them as willful defaulters, whatever it is. Ultimately, they said that they can't repay the money back to bank, which means now the asset, which is loan, has become non-performing, which means you're not going to get anything from that particular asset. Then it will be classified as NPA. There are certain rules for classifying NPA, like for these many days, if you are not getting interest, then you should classify the so-called asset as NPA and all. I'll not try to go in depth, because this is not a commerce class. So I just want to give you a basic idea for those people who don't have any idea with respect to what NPA is. So to put it simple, NPAs are nothing but the loans given by banks to people like Vijay Mallya, Nirav Modi, and in return, after some years, it has come to the conclusion that these loans will never be repaid. Therefore, these loans are no longer assets for banks, and therefore they will classify that into the category of NPAs, that is non-performing assets, which is very bad for the bank. In fact, NPAs are so bad for the bank that ultimately it will lead to closure of the bank as well, right? Anyway, chalo, let's move on. So obviously, is it bad for the economy? Yes, it is very much bad for the economy. It really hurts the economy of a country. So it's a mess. So that's why it is referred as NPA mess. Now the question is, how to tackle this NPA? Everybody wants to solve this NPA. Now the question is how to solve it. Obviously, the solution is not going to be easy. That's why the heading is no easy solution. Right? Chalo, let's move on. Okay, this was the news. Let's try to understand the news first. So Piyush Goyal, who is currently in charge of the finance ministry, has announced the formation of a committee to assess the idea of special asset reconstruction companies. So ARCs, generally they'll be referred as, that is asset reconstruction companies or asset management companies, whatever the name, to take over the bad loans from banks. The bad loans from banks is nothing but NPAs, as you already know. So they are actually thinking of forming a separate entity called Special Asset Reconstruction Company or Asset Management Company, such that the intention is after forming these entities, they will take over the bad loans from the banks. What do you mean by take over? Simply saying they'll buy the loans from banks. Loans are assets. Please try to understand. So they'll buy the loans from banks. The bankers panel has been given 2 weeks to revert. The idea of a bad bank is not new. Okay. So what do you mean by bad bank here? The bad bank is nothing but the, you know, entity that they are planning to form. So it will be called as bad bank. Okay. What it will do is that it will buy all this kind of NPAs from banks. Okay. Such that the banks are relieved of that NPA stress and they'll start issuing what? Loans. Are you able to get me? Yes. Chalo, let's move on. So this idea of bad banks is not new. What idea? Bad banks idea. Why it is not new? Because see here, Chief Economic Advisor Aravind Subramaniam had suggested already the creation of Public Sector Asset Rehabilitation Agency in Economic Survey itself. So there is something called Economic Survey. I don't know how many of you are aware of this. It's a government-based document. And in this Economic Survey, Chief Economic Advisor Aravind Subramaniam has already stated there's a need to establish an entity called PERA, which is a Public Sector Asset Rehabilitation Agency, to deal with what described as India's festering twin balance sheet problem. What do you mean by this twin balance sheet problem? We'll try to understand. Are you able to get me? So this PERA is now referred as bad bank. So any name that you give, it doesn't matter, PERA or bad bank, ultimately the intention is to ultimately solve the NPAs or twin balance sheet problem. So what do you mean by this twin balance sheet problem? We'll try to see now. So what is this twin balance sheet problem? Many of you doesn't know. So let's try to understand. It means over leveraged corporates unable to service debt or invest afresh and banks hit by non-performing assets. KG about fresh lending as well. This overhang hurts new investments and continues to dent India's medium-term growth and job creation prospects. What do you mean by this? Let's try to see. Suppose you have got a company on this side and bank on this side. So company has taken loans from bank. So for bank, the asset will be loans given to companies. And on the balance sheet of the company, it will be liability. What is the liabilities? Bank loan, right? Now, banks has given loans to company saying that obviously, what will be the intention? Company will use that money. It will invest in its own business, like infrastructure business or whatever it is. Ultimately, it will earn something out of the business and eventually it will repay the bank. So now what's happening? Whatever the projection that they have made in the years of 2007, 8, 9, 10, all these things have gone down because of the recession. And as a result, their business are down. And as a result, they were not able to pay the bank loan. So here they have a liability, they can't pay the existing liability, are able to get me, and therefore they cannot get new loans, which means they can't get funding. Who can't get funding? Company. If companies can't get funding, how can they do business? Are able to get me? Why they are not getting funding? Because already the existing funds that they have received in the form of loans are not being repaid. So which means they can't get any further funding, which means their business is stuck, which means the whole country as such is stuck. Same problem is with respect to bank as well. Banks has given loans to these companies and these loans have turned out to be NPAs, which means company is not in a position to pay to bank, which means now bank cannot get the money that it has given, which means because of this stressed loans or NPAs, bank cannot give further loan because already it is under stress. So which means on one side, the funding is stopped, because of banks facing this problem in their balance sheet. And at the same time, companies also can't get new money because already they are stuck with this problem in their balance sheet. So this is referred as twin balance sheet problem. On one side, the companies, they can't pay the loans in their balance sheet. And as a result, they can't get new funding. Thereby, their business is stuck. And on the other side, banks, on the asset side, they have their loans, which they have given and they are not getting repaid. Therefore, because the existing loans that they have given are not getting repaid, they cannot provide newer loans, and therefore here also funding is stuck. Ultimately, this is referred as twin balance sheet problem, which has led to stuck of the economy, which means the entire economy as a whole has started slowing down. I mean, the growth has started slowing down, and almost you can say it is in a dormant period, because it's a very serious thing for the economy of the country as such. I hope now you have understood what is twin balance sheet problem, correct? Let's move on. Over leveraged companies means, please understand, leverage means advantage. When you'll have an over advantage, I'll not try to go in depth, but just understand, over leverage means over debt. That's it. Simple understanding. What do you mean by over leveraged corporates? Which means over debt corporates, which means those corporates which have taken too much of debt. So therefore they are unable to service debt, which means they can't pay the debt, or they can invest afresh because they don't have money. Because of not servicing the existing debt, they are not getting money. Are you able to get me? Therefore they can't invest afresh, which means they are stuck. And at the same time, banks are also hit by non-performing assets. Therefore, they are cagey about fresh lending, which means they cannot give fresh loans. This overhang hurts new investments and continues to dent India's medium-term growth and job creation prospects. Many of the public, they're having this basic doubt, jobs are not there, jobs are not there, jobs are not there. This is the problem. This is the major problem, why jobs are not getting created. How jobs will be created when companies will start doing their business, when they start investing further, when they start opening new branches? Are you able to get me? When the companies are stuck here, and on the other side, companies need money and banks are not in a position because banks are also stuck. Thereby, there will be no question of job creation. This is the problem. It has got nothing to do with government. Please understand that, okay? Always blaming some X, blaming some Y, blaming some Z. Stop this blame game. Please stop this blame game. It is easy to blame. Congress will blame BJP, BJP will blame Congress. That's an easy game here. Let's try to understand what is the main problem, where the problem is. I already told you in my previous video that the problem of this NPA is not due to either of the governments. Maybe like 5 to 10%, yes. Maybe they would have influenced through their ministers where some ineligible people would have got loans and thereby they are not in a position to repay that back, which would have led to NPAs. Correct. But what about 90%? It was in the golden period. I already told you, in the period of 2008-2007, before the recession, it was a golden period for the entire globe. Every country was growing at the fastest pace ever. GDP was growing like anything. And therefore, everybody was optimistic. And therefore, when they have given their projections, business projections to the banks, they were really optimistic, and banks were also happy because they know that these guys will do business because the entire economy as such of the whole world is growing at fastest pace. So banks have given loans. Ultimately, what has happened? In anticipation of getting the money in return. So they are not at fault, basically. Please try to understand. Unfortunately, after that, what has happened? The recession has stuck and their business has started falling down. And as a result, the companies can't repay the money. And therefore, banks can't get the money, which means they also can't give any further loans, and everybody is stuck, thereby hitting the economy hard where it hurts. So where it hurts, job creation. Jobs are not getting created. If you want jobs to get created, then you should ensure that the banks will lend money. Or let me put it this way. If you want jobs to get created, then you should ensure that the companies will start investing afresh. So what you have to do, if companies have to start investing afresh, you need to make funds available for the company. How can you make funds available for the company? You have to ask banks to give them loans again. How can you make banks to give loans again when they're already stuck with NPA problem? Then you create something called a bad bank or the asset rehabilitation agencies, PARA, right? Which we have already seen, right? Public sector asset rehabilitation agency or bad bank. Whatever the name that you call it, doesn't matter. And ask this bad bank to buy the NPAs from the public sector banks, and thereby the public sector banks will be relieved, and thereby they'll come forward to give further funding to the companies, and thereby the companies will get money, and thereby the companies will start investing afresh, and thereby jobs will be created. Do you understand the chain of the whole thing? I hope you are getting crystal clear clarity, right? The whole chain. This is the solution. Right, let's move. So what is the solution? Just now, a professionally run PARA, public sector asset rehabilitation agency, or the so-called bad bank, whatever the name, could assume custody of the largest and most difficult to resolve NPAs from lenders' balance sheets, which means lenders means bankers. So you buy those NPAs from the bankers. This would allow banks to focus on extending fresh credit, so banks will start giving fresh loan and supporting the pickup in the growth. More importantly, a bad bank taking tough decisions on borrowers gone bad, it was argued, could free bankers from the risk entitled in the large loan write-offs. You got the point? Right, this is what the solution which we have already discussed. Chalo. So why the finance ministry left the bad bank idea? Bad bank, or you can also call it as para, whatever it is, whatever the name it is. Actually, this was the idea, but they have kept this idea in dormancy. Dormancy means they have just kept it like that since last, 1.5 years or so. And they have not at all taken this forward. Reason, because the idea of bad bank or para has got some limitations in it. What is that? We'll try to understand. The fact that the new entity would need a lot of capital support, just as banks do. Because you want somebody called para or bad bank to buy the NPAs from existing public sector banks. How will you buy? By paying money, which means you should have the capital support, right? Otherwise, how can you buy? And this capital support has been a major problem for the bad banks or the para, whatever it is. Setting up a new institution would be very time consuming, obviously. Setting up a para or bad bank is not just overnight thing. It takes a lot of effort and time consuming. So there would be challenges on its ownership structure as well, whether it will be completely owned by government, this para or bad bank, or it will be public-private partnership, or it will be private sector. We don't know. Right. So the structure is pretty much uncertain, as well as the pricing of bad loans taken over from banks are also question mark, which means at what price you will buy these bad loans from what banks is a debatable thing. Nobody has got clarity over it. All these things are stopping the finance ministry from executing this particular idea of bad bank. In any case, going by the experience of private asset reconstruction companies, a para by itself would not be able to deploy dramatically different tools to extract better value from underlying assets and would at best amount to window dressing bank books to attract what? Investors. So what here could happen is, it's very difficult for you to get the capital support. Who? The bad bank or para? Why? Because the para is purchasing something called non-performing assets. Which means nobody will be interested to invest in para, because the business of para is to buy what? Non-performing assets, which itself is very risky. So therefore, what could happen is, maybe they would like to buy these loans and they'll do window dressing. Window dressing means what? There is a window, but you will dress it to create an illusion that there is no window. That's what you mean window dressing, which means you try to cover up the fault. You try to cover up a hole, then that is referred as window dressing. So what these para will do is that, in order to attract the investors, because para needs capital investment, only if para gets capital, then only para can buy the bad loans from the bank. So therefore, to attract the investors, what para can do? It can do window dressing with respect to its own assets, saying that, yes, there is a greater chance of buying, getting money through these non-performing assets. And therefore, it may attract what? Investors. And finally, a government-owned bad bank could still face scrutiny from either CAG, which is Comptroller and Auditor General, or CVC. What do you mean by CVC? Central Vigilance Commission. So even though it is government-owned, still it will attract what? Scrutiny from these two guys, right? So what's the current situation then? For now, the government is clearly under pressure to demonstrate fresh intent to investors, as India Incorporation as such believes bank loans are likely to remain sluggish for the next 2 to 3 years, which means sluggish means what? Even for next 2 to 3 years also, there will not be enough banks giving good amount of loans, because this NPA problem is not going to get solved. It will take time to get solved. Till it gets solved, the credit growth will be very bad and the banks are likely to remain sluggish. Sluggish means they'll not be that excited in giving new loans unless their NPA problem is sorted out. So whether or not the knots in the bad bank idea are sorted out, the government should focus on other reforms as well. So you don't just concentrate on this bad bank idea. Okay, it's a good idea. But in addition to that, government should concentrate on other things also. What do you mean by other things and why it is important? Let's try to understand. One, amend the Prevention of Corruption Act to shield bankers and officers from investigative witch hunts. For example, why this is important? Let's try to understand. Suppose there is SBI Bank. And SBI Bank has given a loan to, for example, somebody called, Nirav Modi, let's say, Nirav Modi. Are you able to get me? So now these guys, when they take bold decisions, I'm talking about the bankers, when they take bold decisions in trying to get the money from these guys who are willful defaulters, so they can take decisions like taking hard steps to recover the money, or they may take steps to write off these loans. When these kind of decisions are taken by some bold bankers, then the Prevention of Corruption Act should be amended in such a way that these bankers are protected and they are not tortured or subject to what? Witch hunting from the investigative guys. Are you able to get me? So normally what happens, suppose you are a banker of SBI and you have given loan to somebody called Nirav Modi and that guy is not in a position to pay it back. Now what you can do, you have two choices. Either take some bold steps to recover the money, so go out of box and then try to recover the money, or you can try to write it off, which is good than covering it up, right? So when these kind of things are done, then immediately these investigation officers will come and they'll start torturing or questioning that particular bank manager. Why you have written off this loan? What was the reason? Do you have any sort of interest in writing off this loan? Did you receive anything? And all this kind of witch hunting will be done, which needs to be stopped, which means you have to amend the Prevention of Corruption Act. And the second thing is to back bankers to take demonstrable action against willful defaulters. That's what I was saying here. So there is a banker in this SBI, some particular person, he has to take some bold step, I mean bold steps to recover the money from Nirav Modi. If there are bankers like that who are taking bold steps to recover money from willful defaulters like Vijay Mallya and Nirav Modi, then you should back them, you should support them. Are you able to get me? These are all the things that has to be done besides this idea of para or bad bank. Are you able to get me? Chalo. So the final conclusion is, so finally, can we resolve the NPA mess? No, the answer is that the NPAs are here to stay. But because a bad bank or this para idea, it is not a magic bullet. Tackling NPA requires other structural reforms as well. And that's the other structural reforms which we have seen here. One is amending Prevention of Corruption Act, and the other one is supporting the bankers, whoever is trying to get the money from these willful defaulters in an aggressive manner. Are you able to get me? So we need these other structural reforms in addition to bad bank. And just don't come to a conclusion that just because bad bank is established or just because para is established, whatever the name you're going to call, immediately the NPAs will be, the NPAs will be what? Solved. So don't come to a conclusion. So the final answer is NPAs are going to stay for at least another 2 to 3 years, and that will have an effect on our economy. But at least you can do this at the earliest. That is the final conclusion. Are you able to get me? Right, guys, I hope you have enjoyed this particular video. If you have really enjoyed, yes is your answer, then hit that like button without even thinking. And most importantly, comment. Comment and share it to your social media so that people will understand what the NPAs are having. Because if you share this video, then definitely you'll be helping our society in an indirect way. Why? Because people now, they'll have an idea why this NPA has been created and how people are trying to solve this. Otherwise, just like all the other people on social media, some group will be scolding Congress, some group will be scolding BJP, and some group will be scolding both of them. So let's stop this scolding nonsense or blaming game. Let's try to be a little bit mature. And for that, I need your help, because I've taken my part and I've made this video so that I want to make people aware that this is a real thing that's happening. And what's your responsibility? Comment and share this particular video. Help me to ensure that this video will reach more number of people. Thereby, let's cut this nonsense such that let's let people know that this is what is happening, and thereby people are not getting fooled by any news channels or anybody else. I hope you guys are going to support me in this endeavor, and I'm 100% sure that you will support me. So please comment and share without fail. So this is PK sir signing off with lots of love, and thank you guys and all the best. Jai Hind.